talk about art, you need two things. You need a group of art called fine art, and you need a common principle for what's going on in that group. The system and the group of techniques that were chosen to be the fine arts came rather late. Many constellations were tried, and it was not clear, not even at the time of Kant, we actually had it. So you had to wait until you come into the 19th century before there was this firm group of fine arts, you know, the painting, sculpture, music, literature, song, theatre, dance, architecture. And then you need a principle, and for that you need a special aesthetics, a beauty which is different from ordinary beauty. And this difference is a difference in a mystical way, unexplained, undefinable. So that begins.
Poetry cannot, except at the price of death or decay, assume the mantle of science or morality. The pursuit of truth is not its aim. It has nothing outside itself. Produce this monstrosity.
Reality and art are very different.
Money, that will shoot you by mistake.
Regard for concrete reality.
What do you paint then?
What's in my head? Art's an abstraction, not a picture book. A painting is a flat surface covered with lines and colors arranged in certain order.
Yeah, but Theo, Paul, what about the arrangements that exist in nature?
I choose to disregard nature. What I'm after are harmonies. Harmonies of pure color, deliberately composed and carefully calculated that move you as music moves.
But then you deny the greatest artists of all, Rembrandt, Rubens, Delacroix, Millet.
Millet? That calendar artist with his dun-colored tones and sentimental insipidity.
How dare you say that? Millet's one of the few artists that ever really captured the human spirit and the dignity of toil. Millet uses paint to express the word of God.
Well, then he should have been a preacher, not a painter. If there's one thing I despise, it's emotionalism in painting. Vincent,
painting
is for painters.
Like your friend Degas, I suppose, who's done nothing but ballet dancers and racehorses for the last 10 years.
You can learn something from him. You can learn control.
I don't want control. I'm not afraid of emotion. When I paint the sun, I want to make people feel it revolving, giving off light and heat. When I paint pheasant in the field, I want to feel the sun pouring into him like it does in the corn.
What do you think you're doing when you overload your brush? When you slap paint on like putty? When you make your trees writhe like snakes and your sun explode all over the canvas? With all your emotion, what I see when I look at your work is just your paint too fast.
You look too fast.